greetings for the day. Extensive survey project. A new tank project that is designing of an earthen dam for the drinking purpose and other irrigation purposes, this project is being conducted. So this will be our current project area. This is located in Karnataka, Bangalore. The place is Muktinaga Temple. So in this location, we will be conducting our full survey course, that is extensive survey project in this location. And the location is in 12 degree 54 minute and 53 second north latitude and 77 degree 25 minutes and 21 second east of longitude. So the latitude longitude of the project location is being dropped here, and this is the temple. So throughout this project, you will be taking the benchmark as the sill level of this temple. So it will be given at the project site. So from this benchmark, you have to take a temporary benchmark for each and every project. So this is the permanent benchmark you should assume for all the 5 projects. You should conduct a fly leveling and you should locate a temporary benchmark under your site location. So by doing this map study, you know that what are the hindrance and difficulty while proceeding a survey of a location. So this part of area will be taken for the layout planning and water supply and sanitary work. So you will be considering this area. And for highway project, you will be given 2 points. And finally, the third section is new tank project and restoration tank project. So the area will be adjacent to this point. So in detail, we will be looking in those projects. Now, let us concentrate the first project, that is a new tank project. So what do you mean by that? In a particular location, so we can conceptualize that in this area which we looked earlier for a layout planning. So in that location, people need water for drinking purpose. So you can create a earthen bund. If you have a natural runoff, then you can create a earthen bund and the water can be stored for drinking and irrigational purposes. So if you are identifying the runoff area, that is a bund. So through this bund, the water will be flowing in the seasons. So if you construct a earthen dam in those bund, you could be able to store the water, and this stored water can be used for drinking purposes and irrigational purpose. For irrigational purpose, you can take a canal vent here. So in this part of area, a natural embankment is created, and above that, this will be upstream side and this part will be downstream side. The place where you are constructing the dam will be the neutral level. So the amount of water, how much of amount of water can be stored here, and is it sufficient? And what about the annual rainfall? You can identify everything and you can predict the amount of water which can be stored through this dam. So here you will be constructing a weir. So weir is a structure where you can store the water and you can use those water for other purposes. And there is a difference between weir and a dam. So dam is majorly used for storing the water for a long time, and in case of weir, there might be overflow in weirs. So there will be, due to the overflow of water, so you can deviate those water to the waste weir, so which we will discuss. So the new tank project consists of reconnaissance survey for selection of site and conceptualization of the project. And second part is alignment of center line of proposed bund. So we will be identifying a bund and we will be conducting a survey along the cross section of the bund. So this will be the water flow, and towards the perpendicular point of this flow, we will be constructing a earthen embankment. Okay, so for constructing this weir, we will be conducting a longitudinal section and cross section survey in order to locate a best place to store the water requirement. And next thing is a detailed survey required for project execution, like capacity survey. And the capacity survey identifies the total amount of water which can be stored through this weir. Next thing is details of waste weir. So the waste weir is a weir which is constructed as a part of this dam, and the overflow of the water which will be transferred through the waste weir, and a sluice. Sluice is a gate which will be operated along the weir. It can open the flow of water. Next one, canal alignment. So this will be aligning the canal to supply water for irrigational purpose. And last part is design and preparation of drawing with report. After conducting the survey, you will be designing the structure. So first part is conducting the survey for new tank project, and after that you will be designing the structures. So this is the second part of this project. Okay, now let us come into our project. So this is the location, which is Mukti Naga temple. From that, we will be considering this area for the new tank project. So our people will be staying in this layout plan. So I am creating a concept here. So for the people need, we will be dragging the water from this area. So a bund is available in this location. So we will be constructing a earthen dam, and the components, so this water can be used for supplying this part of residence. Okay, the objective of our project is to propose construction of an earthen dam across valley through which a stream is flowing, and to store the water in order to utilize it for irrigation. So you can see a bund here. So there is a natural drop down, and we can see the natural water flow, expected water flow. We can create a obstruction here. So what will happen during the season, the water will be flowing here, and the flowing water could be stored for other purposes. Okay, so this is the components of a earthen dam. So through this runoff you can create a dam here, and the top part will be upstream side and the bottom part will be downstream side, and this will be the neutral axis. You will be conducting the longitudinal and cross sectional survey in this part. Okay, next, this is emergency spillway. What will happen if the water is more than the capacity of this dam? There will be a place in order to evacuate this overflow of water, in order to stabilize this dam. This emergency spillway will help the water to overflow. And next thing is, there will be a intake structure. So we can take the water by designing this intake structure. What will happen? The water will be stored, water will be in, will be taken here, and through the pipe it will be taken to the outlet, and from this outlet we can distribute to the people. And for irrigation purpose, you can take this waste wear water. So this waste wear water could also be used for irrigation purpose. And the top part is called the crest, and you are having a drain here. Okay, this is a dam structure. So in a dam you will be having a spillways, and the intake structure is constructed here, and through a pipe the water is being transferred to the treatment plant, and after the treatment plant the water can be supplied to the people. And also you can see a axillary spillway. A spillway is otherwise called a weir, a waste weir. And next thing, see, you can observe a earthen dam, and the waste weir is constructed along the part, along the earthen dam, as a part of the dam. So you are going to design, you are going to locate the dam and weir, canal, etc. So the components of the earthen dam are, this is the top width, and a dam is constructed for a bottom width of slope. So you will be having a slope according to the standards. The water is stored in the upstream side, and this is known as the freeboard. So the water which is over the freeboard will be taken to the waste weir. So some part of water will be stored here, and for safety purpose the remaining water will be taken through the waste weir. Okay, next, coming into the survey part, we have understood what do you mean by a tank and what are the components. Now let us understand the survey part. So now we will be understanding the longitudinal and cross sectional survey along the proposed center line of the tank bund. So our objective is to obtain a profile of valley along the assumed center line of the dam. So you will be having a, see, this is also a bund here, the natural water flow is here. What we are going to do is, we are going to do a survey here. The type of survey is known as longitudinal section and cross section. What is the purpose of conducting this survey? If you identify the amount of soil which is required in order to construct this dam, after conducting the survey you will be knowing that the amount of soil which is required to construct the dam. and to estimate the quantity of earthwork for proposed construction. So this is what the two parts. And for conducting the survey, you need a theodolite withstand and level withstand. So you can use dumpy level. In a particular purpose, you can use a theodolite. So if according to the condition, the type of instrument is varied. A leveling staff, chain with arrow, tape, ranging rods, compass, withstand and wooden pegs. So these are the equipment is required. Okay. So let us proceed with this survey. How to conduct this? First, you should establish the temporary benchmark. So I earlier indicated that you need a you have a permanent benchmark at Muktinaga temple, and what you have to do is you have to start a fly leveling, and through that fly leveling you can locate this temporary benchmark, and by that you can fix your instrument along with this place. So in this area you can fix your instrument at a particular place where all the points are visible. Okay, then leveling is started from the benchmark established near the bund. Fix a point C1 along the center line of the bund which has elevation of 3 meter higher than the proposed top bund. Its thinness is assumed as 0. Yes. Say for example, you have to equally split this area. You have to equally split this length. So, and each and every point you can plug the pegs or arrows. So, in the terminals points, you can locate the pegs, and a ranging rod can be used. Okay. After fixing the points, you can conduct a chain survey and identify the length, and you can equally distribute this points. And next thing is positioning of theodolite station for precise alignment of center line of the bund. So this is known as the center line of the bund. You have to set up the instrument at a commanding position approximately along the proposed center line. So in a steep ground, it is given that 7.5 of peg interval. So these two interval, this is a guideline, you can use this, or according to the site you can make your decision. And for a steep ground you can take this as 7.5 meter, and for a flat to mild slope you can use the distance as 10 meter. The RL of each point should be identified by using the dumpy level. Okay, then what about the cross section? First we have done the longitudinal section, and next we are proceeding with the cross section. For each and every point, that is C1, that is chainage 1, this is 0 chainage, the C8 should be at the same level of C1. So C1 and C8 should be at the same level. Okay, now we have plotted all the points in the ground, and what we have to do is we have to do a cross-sectional survey, and this is a model of observation. You have to locate the pegs here, number of pegs or arrows which is taken, and distance. So the C1 will be at 0 chainage and C2 will be at 0 plus 10. So the distance would be your assumption, and so on you can take up to C8. So for example purpose it is given up to 100. Next you can take the staff reading, that is backside. You have to look into the, you will be providing the instrument somewhere where all the points are visible. So from that you can take the backside with temporary benchmark and intermediate site for each and every point, C1, C2, C3. For all the points, you can take the intermediate site, and for the last C8 point, you can take the fore site. So you can complete a single set of reading, and you can find the reduced level either by using rise and fall method or height of instrument method or height of collimation method. You have to find the RL of each and every point. Now this is longitudinal section. Circular line from left side, also from the right side. So let us look into this. Now first thing what we have done is longitudinal section is over, and now in order to see the tank has a particular slope. This slope could be 2.5:1 at the upstream side and 2:1 at the downstream side. So in order to work in the breadthwise of this tank, we need cross-sectional survey. So this is the center line, and from this you will be taking readings from both left and right hand side. So how to decide the total length of cross section? So you can take 2.5 times top bund level. So this is TBL. So this is top bund level, which is the highest point. So at this point the chain edge will be zero. So this is the top bund level, which you can assume it as 5 meter, and this is the ground level. This is the steepest point of the bund. So now if you find both the RL, now you can find, you have to minus this. If you minus into, then you multiply by 2.5 plus 20, you will be getting the cross-sectional distance in terms of meter. And for downstream side also you can use the same formula, and you can find the total distance of cross-sectional measurement. You can separate into number of equal section, and you can proceed the cross-sectional survey. The permanent benchmark are established near the center line of the bund. This should be accessible even after the construction of the proposed bund. So where you will be providing the temporary benchmark will be the permanent benchmark after the construction, so that you should make sure that providing a proper temporary benchmark is, should be accessible after the construction also. The temporary benchmark should be left at suitable intervals to facilitate checking of cross-section levels, and the survey is continued till the point C8 along the alignment which is having the same level as C1. This is what I have discussed. So the technical parameters you should know. This is the top bund level, and this is MWL, this is maximum water level. Up to this point you can store the water. So this is full tank level, FTL. After this, what do you mean by full tank level? In this level the water is stored, and the water which is flowing above the full tank level, that is up to maximum water level, these water will be flowing through the waste weir. So these are the waste water which you could use for other purposes. So above that the water cannot rise, so that the waste weir is constructed to ensure the security of this dam. And okay, so after taking the reading from the field book, you have to plot a graph. So you can use a A1 graph sheet, and from this graph sheet you will be knowing the reduced level of the center line. So you can take this as y-axis, and in x-axis you can make a chain edge. So the total length will be the chain age. You can take the total length, say for example, if it is 20 meter, you can equally distribute this 20 meter in the graph sheet and design level. So you will be designing a water tank for a particular height. So you can make this as a design level and OGL center, OGL left and right. So you could measure the left hand side and right hand side, that is the cross sectional observations you can make here. And from this graph, you can easily identify the amount, the profile. So this is known as profile leveling or longitudinal section and cross section. You can understand the natural level of the proposed area. Okay. Now, as I indicated earlier, so this is full reservoir level. So up to this level, you can see that water can be stored. There is no opening throughout this level. And this is maximum level of the earthen bund. So this water, see, the full reservoir level and maximum flood level, so MFL. So this water is allowed to flow through the weir. So this is a weir structure and this is a dam or earthen embankment. At a particular place only this waste weir is constructed and the water is taken out from this weir. A waste weir on a navigable channel is a slatted gate on each canal level or pond to remove the excess water and to drain the canal for repairs or for a winter shutdown. Even for restoration of water tank. See, if you need to upgrade the level of this tank, so what you can do is this waste weir is used to drain the water and you can make all the construction work, and after that you can use this tank for the next purposes. You can see the weir point here. So this is the earthen bund and the sluice gate are provided here. You can open the sluice gate and all the water could be drained for winter shutdown, and you can make all the construction work or upgradation work. After that you can use this structure. Okay, so when you are going to a location, you should know that where we can locate a weir must be preferably located in the saddle zone in order to minimize the cost of earthwork and protective work. So naturally, if you are having a higher profile, that is saddle point, saddle in the sense hump. So if you are having any saddle point naturally, you can take that point as the weir location. Why? Because you will be requiring a strong obstruction for the flowing of water. This is what I indicated here. This is the deepest level of the waste weir. This will be the full reservoir level. So at this point you can start the weir structure. There must be a natural valley on downstream side to drain off the surplus water, and the length of protective embankment on either side of the waste weir must be minimum. So if you have a place where you are having a rock around this area, so that there will be minimum constructional cost. There must be hard strata available on the downstream side of the waste weir. So the water will be flowing that. So due to this hydraulic jump, the structure, the bottom part will be eroded. So if you have a strong area or strong strata is available, which is very much ideal. So for locating the waste weir, these points should be considered. Okay, second surveying is block contouring survey. First survey we have done as longitudinal section and cross section by using the instrument called dumpy level or theodolite. Now you have to find the capacity of the tank. First survey is done for the earthen dam, and next survey is used to identify the capacity of this dam. For finding this capacity, so full reservoir level, so the top level of the full reservoir should be taken, and the same RL should match the upstream side. So till that you will be having the reservoir. How to identify this area? You can conduct a block contouring survey. So for conducting block contour survey, you need a leveling staff and stand, and chain and arrow, compass, ranging rod, tape and wooden pegs. Okay, so you will be, your location will be like this. What you have to do is, this area, the place where you are constructing the dam, the parallel line should be drawn at the same RL, should be drawn along the upstream side. So what will happen, you will be getting the length of the reservoir, and to identifying the width of the reservoir, what you have to do is, along this length you can draw the lines. The imaginary lines could be drawn by using the chain. You can conduct a chain survey along this RL at both the direction, and you can split it into equal meters, that is 5 meter or 10 meter. You could split this into equal blocks. So for in all the blocks, all the corner of the blocks are being marked as, this is B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. Like that, you can locate all the points throughout the reservoir level. So what you have to do is, you have to place your staff here, and at a particular point near the temporary benchmark, you can locate your instrument. Make sure that while keeping your instrument, all the locations should be clearly visible. If the maximum area is visible, then provide your instrument at that place. You conduct a chain survey and make it into equal blocks. Say for example 10 meter, 10 meter, all the length and width should be equal. And if it is equal, place the arrows at each and every points, and after that place the leveling staff at each and every point and measure the height of all the points. After that, you can take this observation and calculate the reservoir capacity. And this is also another case where you have a pond. So if you have a pond like this, you can identify the capacity of this pond by making into blocks, that is equal length and width. You can make this like this block contouring. These are the points should be noted. Okay, after that you have to plot this in a graph, either in A1 size graph sheet. You can make the RL at each and every point, and you can calculate this area to find the storage capacity. And each and every square of that graph can be calculated as A1, A2, A3. Similarly, up to the total number of square block, and you can find the total volume where h is being the contour interval. H will be the contour interval, and you can find the total volume by using formula which is given below. Okay, then third survey which has to be conducted is creating a map of new tank project. You need a exact map of your location, even though there are many softwares available and a GPS instrument are used to locate a map. So in order to precisely identify, you need a survey. So that is, a plane table survey will be conducted, and all the areas which is covered for this project, that is reservoir as well as the earthen dam and the downstream side, everything should be mapped here. So for mapping that, you will be proceeding with the plane table survey. The same points which you have already used in this block contouring can be used in order to identify the map of this area, and you can conduct either plane table intersection method or radiation method. According to the type of location, you can judicially take your type of plane table survey. Either you can use traversing. According to the area, you can judicially use your technique. You can go through these points. And last thing is canal alignment. The canal alignment is done. All the observations are done in block contouring. So by that values and by that graph, you could be able to set up the canal alignment and follow this guidelines while aligning the canal. There will be a natural level. What you have to do is, you have to excavate certain amount of earth. So this will be calculated for canal alignment. See, there will be a weir which will be located, and after that, when you are getting the block contouring, from that you will be knowing the RL of each and every location, so that you can design the canal alignment. And these are the three major surveys which has to be conducted in order to complete the surveying part of new tank project. First thing is conducting a longitudinal section and cross section survey, and second thing is block contouring, third survey is a plane table survey for creating a map of that location. By this three type of surveying, you can locate all the requirements for design. So after this surveying, we will be designing the structure and completing the project. What is our ultimate aim is to supply the water for the people. So if you know the capacity of your structure, and if you know these three survey, you can design a new tank for the community. I hope you enjoyed this session. Happy learning.